This is about me attempting to book Bryce Wilson group theory into Johannesburg, South Africa. As you know, again, the 90s is massive there. So whether or not he wanted to restart the band was irrelevant. This would have been a good business opportunity move. Now, when they found out Amel wasn't going to be doing the gig, they said, well, if he can find a girl who can sing as well and presents as well, then that's fine. And he had a girl, and they said, fine, she's great. However, they did some checking, and a lot of the fans don't know group theory in South Africa. But they were willing, because of my reputation and Kaya's reputation in the industry for decades, though that is not what she does now, they were willing to go with group theory and the girl that he was going to bring with him. But I don't know, he was problematic from the beginning. He didn't believe who I was because he didn't know me, which I, whatever, you know, but still that was kind of like, okay, you don't know everybody on the planet. That doesn't mean that people aren't working and doing things. And being Canadian also, there was not a lot of promo for artists, black people. It's just been in the last 10, 15 years that there's been work. I'm sorry, a promotion on these people. So I spoke to the promoters, and they were interested just based on what I'm telling them the reputation of group theory was. And they said, okay, well, go for it. It won't be center stage. It would be a Johannesburg festival, which is still a very big deal. So there was this attitude just towards me in general. He didn't believe what I was saying, and I said, well, I invited him to join the chat with the promoters and my friend, who again, like I said, has been in the industry under the quiet for decades. But his attitude of not believing and sort of trying to discredit me was just constant, and I sort of trying to pull him back from that respectfully, but that wasn't going to work. So okay, they decided he would do the Johannesburg Fest, and he said that was beneath him and that he had a proposal. And by that point, because we started in May, by June, July, they decided that he was in no position to present a proposal as an A-lister. Even though he's done a lot of work as a producer and whatnot with many people, they want artists that people in South Africa are familiar with. And they pay up front. So this was the case, but he still didn't believe me, still didn't want to join the chat. So yeah, there was a lot of, you know, don't you know who I am? I've done this, I know what he's done. I know, everybody knows what you've done, even though you don't have the big numbers online. And that, again, just goes to show, just because you don't have a million followers doesn't mean that you're not legitimate. So I was not saying he was not legitimate, but he was saying I was not legitimate, which again was fine. Just, I said, just come and join the chat and you can catch up, which he refused to do. And one thing led to the next. It's just like he became just abusive about everything. But there were things in the conversation that were red flags that I should have known. For one, he didn't appear to believe in God. He called God that nigga. I thought that was probably my out. I should have just gone stage left. But instead I said, you know what, this is about the music. We're just going to keep it about group theory. Okay, so when he offered a proposal, again, they said, well, we think we're going to pass because he's not in a position to ask for a proposal. But he can still do the Johannesburg festival, which is, you know, people like Maxwell and Incognito, people who are still very well known. But more importantly, he would have the opportunity to establish himself in Africa. And I thought, you know, given the type of work he does, all sorts of things, and I believe he wanted access to Africa, this would have given Bryce Wilson access to Africa in a business sense, in every way, shape, and form. But he had a problem with me. You know, you're acting immature. I don't know where all this stuff was coming from. But I think when I look back in retrospect, I realize because they were dragging him on social media about the whole Real Housewives thing, and I don't live that lifestyle. I'm not trying to make money out of dragging people. So, but I didn't realize he made an appearance on that show, and then it became a whole big thing. So maybe that's where his wounded ego was coming from. But that had nothing to do with me. And like I said, I just didn't know about it. So I still tried to proceed with him and say, well, listen, this would be good for you. But not only that, it was good for my reputation. My name was on the, my reputation was on the line. They trusted me regarding several artists, Groove Theory being one for obvious reasons. Even though they didn't have a big catalog, anybody would agree that the work they did was great. And he did have a lot of clout, so I was gonna actually start a venue called Legends Lounge, which has to do with artists like him who have done a lot of work that a lot of people, you know, put the pieces together. It's like, oh yeah, that guy did Beauty Shop, and yeah, he worked with Toni Braxton and did this and whatever. Speaking of which, you know, you all know already, Babyface owes me 23 years worth of royalties for the work I did on Soul Food, wrote and produced and sang on Soul Food, and he made that a big deal. It's like, oh, you hate the world. Why? Because I'm not happy that Babyface ripped me off. You consider Babyface the world? You know, and so things kind of just, they degraded. And I still kind of wanted to sort of hope that he would somehow raise his conscious level here and understand how this would work for him. But he was not trying to have that. I believe he's a woman hater, classic woman hater, because everything he was throwing at me had to do with that and not with the work. So when he tried to propose as an A-lister, they said, forget it, we're going to pass on Bryce completely. This is basically too many problems, too much trouble. So that was off the table. Whatever, because I didn't have a billion follows and a verification at the time. And yeah, so, you know, unnecessary. So, you know, anybody who wants to see what I've done in terms of work, you know, there's a link I'll leave below. You can go see. I'm legitimate just because I'm Canadian and I'm, you know, I'm not American and I don't have a billion follows and a verification doesn't mean that I'm not a legitimate producer, bassist, musician, songwriter, singer. I've made my money doing that with a lot of people. Pretty well started with Alexander O'Neill. That was probably one of the first gigs I did in the 80s when he released this stuff. And I just want to say, I know not every single black man in America is bad, because most definitely Alexander O'Neill, Jimmy Jam, Terry Lewis, and all the guys in Time that we met in Minneapolis are all really cool people. They're all wonderful people. But unfortunately, if all it takes is a few bad apples. It's basically about, is a man who felt the need to drag me down because obviously he feels like crap about himself. It's no wonder you look the way you do, because you know what? Your spiritual, whatever's going on with you spiritually, allowing to go on with you spiritually, it reflects. It's on your face. It shows. And it shows with you. You were invited to join the group chat with the producers from South Africa, if you didn't believe me, but you refused to join them. So to this day, you probably believe I was just talking left. But you know what? I'm so glad that I've come to the conclusion that I don't need or want any of this. I certainly don't need it for money. And I certainly don't need anything. I want nothing to do with the music industry. I'm going into law. Because I am not going to allow people to come left at me like this. Like, this was completely unnecessary. So he decided, after I could not legitimize myself as a promoter for the South African gigs, or even as a musician, he decided to come at me sexually. This goes to show that he truly is a narcissist and a completely woman-hating abuser. I can't trust you, and I'm not surprised that ultimately, when I came at your family, like you continue to come at me and my family, you actually made death threats. Like, what is that? Not interested at all in being around negative, ghetto-ass people. That's what you are. You know what? You present well. You present well. Everybody, any and everybody will say that in an interview. But you know what? That's a narcissist. They will make you believe that they're wonderful people when actually they're horrible people. And you're a horrible person. And it's showing in your face. You came at my family, I came at yours, then you uttered death threats? What is that? What is that? And I have certificates from IBM and Kodak. So every, you know, people have skills. There are people out here with skills. So don't put your baby mama on my level, because I would never do a show like The Real Housewives of whatever that it is they do. And now I understand why you felt the need to drag me around the time I met you. You went on that show and everybody started to drag you, and you were projecting. So that's what you're doing. You're making it all about me, when this really should have been about something that really do you would have been amazing. You know, you're into real estate, you're into so many types of businesses that the continent Africa would have presented such great opportunities for. But that wasn't good enough for you. You, for some reason, you felt the need to denigrate me, to make me feel as though I'm doing something bad to you. Oh, I won't grow up. I'm going to block you if you don't shut up. You're acting like an idiot. Whatever, whatever, you know. Again, I'm glad I ended up cutting it off. I'm glad, because what you did was you dragged my energy down so low that it was depressing. You know, I had a gig. I had a gig had some work offered by Billboard. I was negotiating, and Elder Barge ruined that. And I have all the screenshots. I will post all that stuff on another day. But right now, I just want to talk about this here. So he ruined that opportunity with Billboard. We're talking about hundreds of thousands of dollars, if not close to a million, because even Babyface, I've said before, I did work, I composed and produced and sang on work on Soul Food, and you refused to pay me. To this day, that work was done in 2000. So I have every right to feel the way I feel about you people, you see. I was brought up properly. There are actually people who come from very meager beginnings and go on to do great things, like a lot of you. But hey, it seems to me you still choose, instead of focusing on what you're doing, go over there and try to destroy what someone's got going on there. Maybe that's why Black Americans don't have anything and get nowhere. That's why Black people, period, cannot get from point A to B. You start at slavery. Is that where your history begins? Guess what? Mine begins when we were great, and we are great. And I will always believe that, because that's how I was raised. I come from a good family, and we didn't have to deal with a whole lot of the bullshit that you all dealt with, because you know, my grandparents and parents never felt beneath white people. They just succeeded. They simply succeeded. And I'm a product of that, and I will always continue to be proud of that. One thing I will not do is have a Bryce Wilson come up and destroy and try to fuck with me. For what? What was your purpose? Did it fulfill you? Are you happy? Are you satisfied? Yeah, you present well. Not good enough. You're a narcissist. That's what you are. You cost me my reputation. But it's just as well, because everything bad that happens always has a good outcome, somehow. I never enjoyed being in the music industry. So there you go. I worked with children before, and what we have coming up, I'm going into law, and what I have in Barbados will facilitate that. That's the flex I'm on. It's about our kids. It's not about our damn egos or trying to get laid. I dodged a bullet, Bryce Wilson. I dodged a bullet. Whether you people want to believe this, watch this, I don't care. But you know what? Like I said, nobody is going to disrespect me, try to drag me down for no reason, and then expect anonymity from me. I'll put you out here. I'll put you out here. They can still love you, because a lot of thirsty women, no matter what anybody says, no matter what you do, there are a lot of thirsty women who will still consider you desirable. I'm not one. I'm not one. And I'm not the one. Okay? So you, babyface, the DeBarge, half-breed boys, whatever, do what you do, be who you be, but I want no part of it at all anymore. None of you will have access to me. And I mean that in every way. So, Vice, Kilson, save your death threats. Everybody has people. You will not have access whatsoever to me anymore. Have a good day. That's all.